家好，我是 Stella，
我是乌龙。我们今天要为你念的是《列举总数》第342课：文苑宽恕，灵性于万物，如此我才会蒙受宽恕。Listen 第三句 42， I let forgiveness rest upon all things, for thus forgiveness will be given me。让我们现在送吧。
我愿宽恕灵性于万物，如此我才会蒙受宽恕。 I let forgiveness rest upon all things, for thus forgiveness will given me。 我愿宽恕灵性于万物，如此我才会蒙受宽恕。I let forgiveness rest upon all things, for thus forgiveness will given me。
天父，我感谢你，因你的计划将我由自己营造的地狱中拯救出来了。 I thank you, Father, for your plan to save me from the hellI made。 这地狱不是真的， It is not real。 你也赐给了我种种方法证明它的虚假不实。 And you have given me the means to prove its unreality to me。 我已经来到梦境终点的那一扇门，手中握着它的钥匙。 The key is in my hand, and I have reached the door beyond whichlies the end of dreams。 立于天堂门前的我仍在犹豫是否应该进入重返家园。 I stand before the gate of heaven, wondering if I should enter in and be at home。 愿我今天不再迟蹰。 Let me not wait again today。愿我宽恕一切，让整个造化恢复你创造它的原貌，那才是它的真相。Let me forgive all things, and let creation be as you would have it be and as it is。愿我记住，我是你的圣子，迟早会推开那一扇门，让所有的幻想遗忘在灿烂的真理之光中，那一刻我会忆起你来。 Let me remember that I am your son, and opening the door at last, forget illusions in the blazing light of truth as memory of you returns to me。 弟兄，此刻就宽恕我吧。 Brother, forgive me now。 我来到你这儿就是为了带你同回家的。I come to you to take you home with me。 只要我们一同迈向上主之路，整个世界便会追随我们的脚步前进。 And as we go, the world goes with us on our way to God。 以下是 Jason 的诗意。 You are blessed beings indeed。你确实是有福之人。 I am that one that you know as Jesus, and the universeknows what you want, it knows what you love, it knows what is in your best interest, and all you have to do is get out of the way。 我是你所知的 JC， 宇宙知道你想要什么，他知道你喜爱什么，他知道什么对你有最大的益处，而你需要做的只是不要挡路。All you have to do is get your foot off the brake of judgment and release it through forgiveness, so that you may accelerate into your chosen path。 你需要做的只是不要用批判来踩刹车， 并且透过宽恕来释放你的批判，这样你才可能加速地进入你所选择的道路。 The path that you choose before you came onto this planet in physical form was built and collaborated between you and your guides and teachers and the experiences you had already had, the experiences that you struggle with.在你以身体的形式来到这个星球之前，你所选择的道路乃是由你与你的向导和老师一起合作建构的。这是根据你已经有过的经验以及令你感到挣扎的那些经验所形成的一项计划。 And a plan was made for your life to bring to you every opportunity to let go ofthat which does not serve you and to expand into that which is love. 使你的人生能够带给你种种机会，让你放下对你无益的一切，并使你扩展而进入爱的世界。 Every single thing that you have encountered gives you an opportunity to practice forgiveness over and over and over again, and it will continue to come to you to give you the opportunity to practice forgiveness.Not to remain in the same place, which is what happens when you continue to judge, but to move you along up and into the realms that you came here to experience. 你所遇到的每件事都给你机会来不断的不断的反复练习宽恕，所以事情会持续来到你眼前给你宽恕的机会。请勿停留在原地，这是你在不断批判时所经历的情况。请顺着这个机会提升自己，进入你来此地想要体验的世界。You did not come here to experience the past over and over again, but there were certain things that were resident with your mind that you needed to deal with.你来此不是要反复地体验过去，但是你心中存在着某些观念，这是你需要面对的部分。 Those things are represented often in your natal family, and your natal family is a big part of your forgiveness practice.那些观念通常表现在你的原生家庭中，因此你的原生家庭在你的宽恕练习中占有很大的比例。You must come to peace with all the members of your natal family over time. When you have come to peace with your natal family, you have finished with the business of what you came in with.一段时间之后，你必须能够平静地面对你原生家庭的所有成员。当你能够平静地面对你的原生家庭时，你便完成了你到此地所要做的事。 Then you can turn to that which you wanted to create. 如此，你才能将焦点转向你想要创造之物。If you have happy relationships with your family, then that was not your assignment in this incarnation. But if you have troublesome, difficult, and abrasive relationships with your natal family, then begin there. 如果你跟家庭成员有着幸福的关系，那么这就不是你这一世的功课。但如果你跟原生家庭有着麻烦的、棘手的、恼人的关系，那么请从这里着手。Begin your forgiveness work there, because you cannot truly move ahead into the most magnificent future.The happy dream until those beings have been forgiven. 请从这里开始做你的宽恕功课，因为除非你已经宽恕了那些人，否则你无法真正往前走，而进入美好的未来，也就是幸福美梦。You merely chose them because they matched you in some way, and that is the greatest realization for many of you to make is that you have an aspect of yourself that matches those beings, those ones that you judge so harshly.你之所以选择他们，纯粹是因为他们在某些方面与你相合，这是你们很多人能够发现的一大事实。换句话说，你有某个面相与你严厉批判的那些人是相同的。 So turn it around. Anytime that you find yourself accusing a family member of something, ask yourself, Am I ever like that?因此，每当你发现自己在为某件事而指控家人时，请回头问问自己，我是否也曾像这样。 And surely you will realize one day, Oh my goodness, I am just like them. It just looks a little bit different in me. Therefore, we are the same. Therefore, I forgive them so that I may be forgiven.必然有一天你会发现，我的天哪，我跟他们一模一样，只不过我的表现方式有点不同而已。所以说我们是一样的，为此我宽恕他们，这样我才能蒙受宽恕。 It is a powerful healing process, this forgiveness practice, and we repeat it over and over and over again because the ego's practice is judgment. Over and over and over again, and one day you will hear us.宽恕练习乃是一个力量强大的疗愈过程，我们不断的不断的反复重申这一点，因为小我会不断的不断的反复的采取批判，终有一天你会听到我们的话。 I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I will speak to you again tomorrow. 我是你所住的 JC, 我们明天再续。
让我们再来唱一次吧。
我愿宽恕临行万物，如此我才会蒙受宽恕。 I let forgiveness rest upon all things, for thus forgiveness will give me. 我愿宽恕临行万物，如此我才会蒙受宽恕。 I let forgiveness rest upon all things, for thus forgiveness will give me.
这句总是第342课。我愿宽恕灵性于万物，如此我才会蒙受宽恕。 Listen 第三句 at 42。I let forgiveness rest upon all things, for thus forgiveness will be given me. 正文第27章，疗愈的梦境 ，Chapter 27 The Healing of the Dream. Leo, 罪的见证 ，6 The Witnesses to Sin.
痛苦证明了身体的真实性。Pain demonstrates the body must be real. 那是一种嘈杂、含糊而又刺耳的声音，让你却答不出圣灵对你说的话。It is a loud, obscuring voice whose shrieks would silence what the Holy Spirit says.And keep his words from your awareness. 痛苦使人无法专注，意识不到圣灵的存在。他会把你整个注意力都集中在自己身上。Pain compels attention, drawing it away from him and focusing upon itself. 他的目的与你寻求的快感一样。两者都是想把身体弄假成真的手段。Its purpose is the same as pleasure, for they both are means to make the body real. 凡是目的相同之物，必属同类。What shares a common purpose is the same. 这是目的的运作法则。This is the law of purpose which unites all those who share in it within itself. 身体的快感和痛苦同样的虚幻，因为他们永远无法达成目的。Pleasure and pain are equally unreal because their purpose cannot be achieved. 因此，这些工具一无所用，是因他们的目标毫无意义。Thus, are they means for nothing? For they have a goal without a meaning. 为此，他们的作用自然也与目的一样，了无意义。And they share the lack of meaning which their purpose has. 坠毁不断由痛苦转为快感，而后又转回痛苦。Sin shifts from pain to pleasure and again to pain. 不论是苦是乐，它只见证了一世，也只给你一个讯息：你活在世上。活在这具身体里头，你会受到伤害。For either witness is the same and carries but one message. You are here within this body and you can be hurt. 你也能享受快感，但必须付出痛苦的代价。You can have pleasure too, but only at the cost of pain. 这类见证有不少狐群狗党。 These witnesses are joined by many more. 每一个看起来都不一样，各有不同的名称，答复着不同的声音。 Each one seems different because it has a different name, and so it seems to answer to a different sound. 除了外观的不同，这里的见证其实全是同一回事。Except for this, the witnesses of sin are all alike. 若把快感成为痛苦，就含有杀伤力。Call pleasure pain, and it will hurt. 反之，若称痛苦为快感，你便感觉不到它背后的痛苦。Call pain a pleasure, and the pain behind the pleasure will be felt.No more. 这里的见证只会不断改名换姓，这个见证上前一步，那个便自行退下。Since witnesses but shift from name to name as one steps forward and another back. 然而不论哪一个走在前面，毫无差别。Yet which is foremost takes no difference.这一的见证只会答复死亡的呼唤。Since witnesses hear but the call of death. 这具身体只是储藏你所有的愿望与记忆而已，没有自身的目的。This body, purposeless within itself, holds all your memories and all your hopes.你用他的眼睛来看，用他的耳朵来听，被他的感觉所控制。You use its eyes to see, its ears to hear, and that it tell you what it is, it feels. 其实他什么也不知道。It does not know. 他告诉你的种种名字，都是你赋予他的，是你为了证明身体的真实性而请来的见证。It tells you but the names you gave to it to use when you call forth the witnesses to its reality. 你无法从这类见证里头决定哪个才是真的。You cannot choose among them which are real, for anyone you choose is like the rest. 你选择的不过是这个名字或那个名字。This name or that, but nothing more you choose. 某一个见证不会因为你称它为真理，它就变成真的。You do not make a witness true because you called him by truth name. 如果他所代表的是真理，你只能在他内找到真理。 The truth is found in him. If it is true, he represents. 否则他就是在撒谎。其实你以上主的圣名来称呼他，也一样无济于事。And otherwise, he lies. If you should call him by the holy name of God himself. 上主的伟大见证不会去看任何对身体不利的证据。God's witness sees no witnesses against the body. 他不会去听那些盯着其他名字或以他种方式证明身体真实的见证。Neither does he hearken to the witnesses by other names that speak in other ways for its reality. 你知道身体不是真的。He knows it is not real.他其实并没有你认为他拥有之物 For nothing could contain what you believe it holds within 他也不可能命令属于上主的你该有什么感觉也该负什么任务 Nor could it tell a part of God himself what it should feel and what its function is然而圣灵必会怜惜你所珍爱之物 Yet must he love whatever you hold dear 他会针对每个死亡的见证为你指派一位生命的见证证明你其实活在上主内而上主的死亡一无所知 And for each witness to the body's death He sends a witness to your life in him who knows no death圣灵带来的每个奇迹都会为你证明身体是虚幻的。Each miracle he brings is witness that the body is not real. 他会撤换罪的一切见证至于身体的快感与痛苦因两者对他却是同一回事。Its pains and pleasures does he heal alike for all things, witnesses,Do his replace. 罪的见证不论化名为何物其实对他们一视同仁 The miracle makes no distinctions in the names by which sin's witnesses are called. 奇迹会向你证明那些名字所代表之物没有任何作用于后果 It merely proves that what they represent has no effect.他证明的方式就是以奇迹之果取代罪的后遗症 And this it proves because its own effects have come to take their place 你把自己的痛苦称作什么并不重要 It matters not the name by which you called your suffering 反正它已不复存在 It is no longer there那些痛苦在带给你奇迹的那一位眼中都是同一回事他一律称之为恐惧 The one who brings the miracle perceives them all as one and called by name of fear 正如恐惧会为死亡作证奇迹就成了生命的见证 As fear is witness unto death so is the miracle the witness unto life没有人否定得了这个见证因它带来了种种生命的迹象 It is a witness no one can deny for it is the effect of life it brings 濒死之人活下来了亡者复生了痛苦也消失了 The dying live the death arise and pain has vanished然而奇迹不是为自己发言它只会为自己所代表的那位发言 Yet a miracle speaks not but for itself but what it represents 爱在这一的世界中也有属于自己的一群象征 Love too has symbols in a world of sin 奇迹之所以有宽恕效果正因它足以代表呢超越宽恕且真实无比的爱 The miracle forgives because it stands for what is past forgiveness and is true 你若认为奇迹会受制于他说治理化解的罪之法则 没有比这更疯狂的想法了。How foolish and insane it is to think a miracle is bound by laws that it came solely to undo. 这一的事例另有一堆见证，而且各有专长。The laws of sin have different witnesses with different strengths. 他们各为不同的痛苦作证， and they attest to different sufferings. 这一点刺痛，那一点欢乐，乃至垂死之痛，对赐予奇迹来祝福世界的圣灵而言，都是同一种声音，那是呼求疗愈的祷声，是这苦难世界所发出的哀嚎。Yet to the one who sends forth miracles to bless the world, a tiny stab of pain, a little worldly pleasure, and the throes of death itself are but a single sound, a call of healing and a plaintive cry for help within a world of misery. 奇迹验证了所有问题都是同一回事。It is their sameness that the miracle attests. 它是为证明这一相同性而来的。It is their sameness that it proves.他就这样解除了世界赋予各种问题不同名称的游戏，是世间法则，从此一蹶不振。The laws that call them different are dissolved and shown as powerless. 这是奇迹说要完成的目标。The purpose of a miracle is to accomplish this. 上主还会亲自为奇迹的见证力量作保。And God Himself has guaranteed the strength of miracles for what they witness to. 去为奇迹作证吧，不要为罪的法则作证。Be you then witness to the miracle and not the laws of sin. 你实在没有继续受苦的必要。There is no need to suffer anymore.你只有疗愈的需要，因为痛苦与哀伤是世界无法听见救恩与解脱的呼唤。But there is need that you be healed, because the suffering and sorrow of the world have made it deaf to its salvation and deliverance. 世界有待你的疗愈及幸福才能重生，你也才能向人证明世界已经疗愈的。The resurrection of the world awaits your healing and your happiness that you may demonstrate the healing of the world. 只要你能展现一点神圣一刻的效果，便足以取代世间的一切罪恶。The holy instant will replace all sin if you but carry its effect with you. 人们就不会继续自找苦吃了。And no one will elect to suffer more. 除了这个任务以外，人间还有什么事情值得你献身？ What better function could you serve than this? 让自己疗愈吧，你才能疗愈别人，且不再受罪的法则所操控。Be healed that you may heal, and suffer not the laws of sin to be applied to you.只要你决心让爱的象征取代罪的见证，真理必会向你启示的。And truth will be revealed to you who choose to let love's symbols take the place of sin.
正文第二十七章，疗愈的梦境 ，Chapter 27 The Healing of the Dream. Leo 罪的见证 ，6.The witnesses to sin. 愿大家有一个生命充满的一天。阿门，我爱你。